the big names have made it on to the main event, including Langston, Ramsey, Short, Ryan Villopoto getting the transfer. Denny, we've seen only one rider, Nathan Ramsey, win two so far this year. Could we see another rider double up tonight?
It's quite possible. Both Grant Langston and Andrew Short, they won each of their heat races. They're coming in with one of the main events win each. But I could look for a spoiler. Michael Essie's really turned things around, looked really impressive in his heat race, as well as Ryan Villopoto and Billy Winninovich.
Time for another Progressive Direct pre-race report. Here's Krista.
One of the sections we definitely have to watch out for in this main event is this sand section, especially for these lights riders. They're carrying so much speed through here, at least they did in the heat races, that by the time they get to that berm, some of them are actually going off the track. These guys are not used to carrying this much speed through a rhythm section. It's getting very soft, all the rest of the track very hard packed, especially coming out of this berm. So watch for this to be a key section for the success of the winner, guys.
Michael Sleater on the KTM number 81, the KTM Sport Motorcycles NCY backed riders, got our helmet cam ready in the main event. There's the view as he lines up in the gate.
Far, far outside.
Yeah. And there's Nathan Ramsey, another KTM rider. He's already won two of these, going for three.
Nathan's been known to winning the most main events during the season, but not winning the title. We need to see if Nathan's going to smooth out, keep that points lead.
Langston, certainly the fastest rider we've seen tonight. Supercross lights West Coast action. Getting himself loosened up and ready to go. He could easily be the next rider to double up Supercross lights victories.
He tore up that heat race, looked really good and strong. Andrew Short, the other guy, took the win. Andrew Short picking up a new sponsor this week, Buku Energy Drink. Joined the battles of Red Bull and Sobe and all the other companies, but nice to see a new company join in with Andrew Short here for this 125 for Lights main event.
Here we go. It looks like Michael Lessie getting the great jump. The KTM rider, the youngster on the 800 with the hole shot.
Langston diving the inside, shutting off the pack, unable to do the double, messed up Andrew Short considerably. Kind of opened up the ground right there for Michael Essie and Nathan Ramsey on the Red Bull KTMs. And Langston went from about sixth to third. A smart move right there, an aggressive move, and kind of a risky move because you can risk getting landed on.
Essie on the number 800. Here goes Short, back and forth.
Villopoto buried in the back of the pack right there. You see him in the sand. Unable to capitalize on a good start like he saw at the beginning of the season, but Michael Essie, no stranger to getting a hole shot.
Well, Denny, here's the situation with Michael Essie as Langston gets inside of Ramsey for second. Here's the story with Michael Essie. We saw this young rider jump out front earlier this year and lead, but then he would drift back. He told you and I earlier today what he's really been working hard on is getting out front of the opening laps, running five laps as hard as he possibly can, trying to pull away and then settling into a rhythm, which is what he's doing right now. But Langston closing in on the outside. Can he get there? Oh, Lessie cuts back on him. Can't get the job done, and Langston's your new leader. Grant Langston takes over the lead.
The word that Lessie used was intensity.
With more, here's Krista.
Yeah, guys, adding on Grant Langston, he's actually working with a different mechanic this week. Aaron Johnson filling in for Dan Rammer. Rammer having a bout of bronchitis. And speaking of bronchitis, back to Michael Essie, he has not been 100%. He has been suffering from bronchitis for the last 6 weeks. He said it's been so bad, sometimes he even blows up while he's on the bike.
And there's Essie sitting back in second place. The other KTM factory rider, Nate Ramsey, tracking him down. Short right behind him in fourth. Here comes Ramsey.
Now, I don't like Michael Essie's line right here. I talked about him getting the show, swinging wide and be able to go triple, but all Mike's doing is opening up the door. That's how Grant Langston just got by him, basically shut the door on him. And he's allowing the guys, you never give the guy the inside line. He's giving it to these guys. Nathan Ramsey, if he comes around the next lap and Mike goes wide, I would expect Nathan to take that line away from him. But Michael Essie, I like what I'm seeing from him. I don't see him looking around. His head's not on a swivel. He's not in panic mode. He's comfortable where he's at. And this. You're not looking around. You're focused on what's going on in front of you.
Very different approach than what we saw with Mike just a few weeks back.
It's confidence. And, you know, each and every race, you're going to learn, especially when you're 17 years old. He's settled to a good pace. Langston obviously got by him, taken off, but he's settled to the second spot. He's got his teammate Nathan Ramsey in his back pocket and Andrew Short right there in fourth. In the early few weeks, Mike Alessi couldn't run this pace.
Let's take a look at the progressive whole shot replay and how this one began with Mike Alessi getting a tremendous jump.
Coming right down the middle of the pipe, Mike Alessi right there just gets a big jump. He's only 135 pounds and he's just wheeling right there. Center of your screen comes and down right down the pipe. But also, look at these guys clipping. They're going down. That's Mike. That's Ryan Villapoto right there. That's what he buried the back of the pack right now because of that reason. But Mike Alessi grabs that whole shot. Yet another in this young man's career out front early. But Grant Langston quickly took the lead and took off. Out of camera range, Nathan Ramsey goes down.
Langston continues to lead. Alessi holding on to second place. We're only a third of the way through this one. And we talked about at the beginning of this race here, Denny, that Grant Langston really showed the class of the field tonight when it came to speed.
Yeah, I mean, we said all season long, he's been the fastest guy. He just made some mistakes. You know, he fell down a couple times, killed the motorcycle another time. But, you know, that's why they race so many races. The cream eventually rises to the top. Grant Langston is making it happen. Definitely hopping through the Camelbacks. He's the strongest guy, and he's out front. He's going to try and close that points gap.
Well, Denny mentioned Nathan Ramsey went down. Here's what happened to the rider of the number 25 KTM machine.
Ramsey was settled into third. This is that section I talked about. He was trying to get on the inside of Mike Alessi. The track's polished. It's shiny. Front end wash, and down he went. He only lost a spot, looks like, to Andrew Short. No, he couldn't get the motor refired. He's back in 17th place. I said it at the end of the show, Nathan's won the most races quite often, but he's always made that one mistake that hurt him and cost him a championship. That might have been that mistake right there.
That's going to cost him a tremendous amount of points tonight. And with the short season that the West Coast Series is, you really can't afford to give up that many points on any night.
Yeah, I kind of jumped the gun maybe last week with Chad Reed saying his crash might have cost him the season. He fought his way back to fifth in the Supercross class. Nathan Ramsey, I'm not going to say it cost him the season if he can come up and make up some points, but he definitely made his season a little bit more difficult winning that title.
Well, especially when it's such a shorter season than bigger Supercross class.
Exactly. They don't have 16 rounds. They only have 8. And I think that the lights class, you know, the speed's a lot more equal than in the Supercross class. He's got his work cut out for him. Nathan Ramsey just shot himself in the foot when it comes to the title, possibly for this West Regional Championship. Grant Langston, on the other hand, he's capitalizing big time out front.
The Monster Pro Circuit Kawasaki back machine of Grant Langston putting in some impressive laps, a 57.3, his best lap of the night, right where he was earlier this evening in his heat race.
Yeah, he knew, he felt he was the strongest guy, the fastest guy. That's why he tried to make quick work. Mike Alessi made an aggressive move on the first lap, went about third to sixth, and quickly just jumped out front. Nothing better than be able to get out front and run your own race and not to worry about anyone else. That's exactly what Grant Langston's doing.
Michael Sleater with our helmet cam runs back in 11th position right now in his KTM number 81. Here's a look at his night. Flying over a triple.
And look at that aggressive move. Michael Sleater gets parked into the tough blocks by Ryan Mills, that number 40 Rockstar Suzuki. That's what it looks like. You don't get a chance to see the guy maybe coming inside and catching you by surprise. Just like that, Michael Sleater's back two spots. Great camera work. Showing what aggressive ride he's done in this last pass.
Here's the Dragonbacks. It's an interesting section.
Yeah, I think that they intended to do just like Michael Sleater was doing it. Run through them, run all the way up to the top of them, both sections. A lot of guys like Grant Langston, I think, Ryan Villapoto, Mike Alessi, they're jumping the first to the bottom of the Dragonback and jumping all the way over the top of it. That's the fast way to get it done.
Grant Langston continues to lead, trying to become the second rider to win two Supercross Lights West Coast races in a year. Stay with us. Langston won the East Coast Supercross Lights Championship. This year, he's trying to take the West Coast title as well. He's well on his way. Looking to get his second win of the season here tonight. Win number two coming his way here in Anaheim. If he can hang on, seven to go in the scheduled 15.
Grant came into this race fourth in points, 10 points behind the leader, Nathan Ramsey. Ramsey's currently buried back in 17th. He's obviously made up that points gap on Nathan, who was 5 points down on Billy Levinovich and 2 back on Andrew Short. Grant Langston, this is tonight, making a big statement and a huge step towards the 2006 West Coast Lights title.
Levinovich runs in sixth right now, the number 132. Short's up in third, so he could even come out of this with the points lead.
He could very well. It just shows how excited his lights class. Last week, he went from fourth to first in the points, and Langston the chance to possibly do the same here in Anaheim.
The thing about it is each week, Grant Langston looks more and more comfortable on the machine. Early rounds of this series, he just had a couple of bobbles here and there. He was right at the front, then something would go wrong. But boy, he's making up a lot of time and really getting his speed back. And if that's going to be the case from here to the end of the championship run, he can end up winning all the remaining races.
Well, when we talked to Langston at the beginning of the season, he said he felt pressure. He felt like he was the guy to beat. And when you instill that kind of pressure on yourself, you know, it can be an uphill battle. And he's obviously pushed through that pressure and settled into that lead, off his West Coast title. And Mike Alessi, another guy I think who kind of dealt with some of that early season pressure.
Well, Mike Alessi sits in second place right now. And remember, he made the podium for the first time last weekend. 2 podiums, 2 weeks in a row, and he's going to move up a step on the podium. Boy, he's going to carry a tremendous amount of momentum with him into next week's race in San Diego.
And momentum, 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 the big mo. We say it every weekend, how important it is. You carry it from week to week, and it's amazing to see the difference of Mike Alessi from the first couple of rounds. Throws it in the, on the podium in the mud in San Francisco. Complete opposite, nice dry conditions, which he struggled in earlier. Now running a solid second in between sandwich between 2 top riders, between Langston and Short.
Short giving chase. Another thing to talk about Alessi is he's been suffering from bronchitis the last few weeks. And here he is, 6 weeks into the bronchitis. He's doing pretty good. Been riding really strong.
But here comes Andrew Short taking a much different line to the rhythm section. Talked about at the beginning of the show. He's choosing to go to the inside and double, and then doubling the tabletops and then tripling out. And I think it's a good second a lap faster than Mike Alessi. And if we come on his next lap, the same thing. If Mike goes wide and Andrew goes inside, it's going to open the door. You could have a possible change for second place. And now Mike Alessi is looking back. You're not looking back. When you're looking
can't
back, you're not looking forward.
Can't do that. Short really had a tough time along those tough blocks, though, on the outside, coming around, getting set for that run through the rhythm section. Oh, and Short cuts to the inside and takes over second.
I can honestly say I'm not sure what that was right there. Mike Alessi just seemed to go, just kind of pulled wide, almost as though he waved Andrew Short by. Maybe Mike's got a little arm pump and realizes that, you know, a third is just as good as trying to hold on to second and crash. You know, that comes from experience and being smart, and I guess he's just saying, hey, if you're going faster than me, go ahead. Maybe I can learn something from you. But I was not surprised by that.
Nobody's going faster than Grant Langston tonight. 57.3, his best lap.
Over a second faster than Mike Alessi at a 58.4, and Andrew Short at a flat 58. So Grant Langston laying it down in this main event.
Just 3 laps left to go.
We talked about to get a season a little bit, because Grant is kind of going for this, not a triple crown, but a quad crown in a sense. He's won a Lights World Championship, won a Lights National Championship, National Motocross Championship, East Coast Supercross Champion, going for the West. No one's ever done that in the history of the sport. He's got a chance to accomplish that goal here in 2006. A pretty big accomplishment, I would say.
With more on Grant Langston, here's Krista.
Really helped him out, Grant Langston, that is. He had surgery on his ankle during the offseason, so he got to do all the testing with the new parts and pieces for the Pro Circuit team. So he said it's actually like getting a little bit of extra seat time, a little bit of extra lap time, and all the new equipment. He said you can't beat time like that.
Langston continuing to just click off the laps. 2 to go.
Riders are out front, spread a pretty considerable distance on the rest of the pack. Langston's got a 5.5-second lead on Short. Short turn has a 2.5-second lead over Alessi. And running fourth, Paul Carpenter, former Monster Kawasaki rider, put in a good effort back and forth right now. Metcalf fifth, Levinovich back in sixth. Villopoto, an incredible ride, powered his way all the way up to seventh.
Well, Langston, Baxton continues to work his way around, and we consider whether or not he's going to take over the points lead if he can hang on to win tonight. Ramsey's only worked his way up to 13th. He's only picked up four more spots. That's not going to help him much in the points.
Well, the difference between first and currently where Ramsey is at 13th, 8 points for 13th and 25 for first. So that's a pretty big points change. Ramsey's now going to go from the points lead to dropping back. But as we've seen in slides class, anything can happen from week by week.
White flag is out for Grant Langston.
Just that easy to be Langston come next week. You never know. It's a very competitive class.
Slater with the onboard camera. Langston winning here at Anaheim the second time we were here just a couple of weeks back. A fourth here in Anaheim 1, a third in Phoenix, then one here in Anaheim 2, struggled in San Francisco, 15th there in the mud, and now another win.
Four of the top five guys all have that one bad place. Ramsey has a 12th in the opener. Short has a 13th in San Francisco. Langston has a 15th in San Francisco, and Villopoto has a 12th at round 3. So it shows that you can have one bad race. Two in an eight-round series, that's pretty hard to make up.
Grant Langston, your winner here tonight in Anaheim. He takes the win on the Kawasaki, his second of the season. Andrew Short comes home in second place on the Honda. Mike Alessi's KTM crosses the line in third. Let's head to Krista.
We've got the winning mechanic, Aaron Johnson. Aaron, you're not usually even out here filling in for Dan tonight. He's got bronchitis. You're doing okay for yourself.
Yeah, it's really hard to replace a mechanic like Dono. He's a great mechanic, and I was just hoping just to do as good a job as he does. He won tonight, and I'm stoked. This is my first win ever, and I couldn't be happier.
All right, go celebrate. We're going to talk to the winning rider in just a bit. Dan, we hope you get well soon, but your team is in good hands until you do.
So Grant Langston takes the win here at Anaheim, and we'll be back to talk to him. Stay with us here on Speed as we're headed to the podium to talk to the winner. Grant Langston is, and so is our Chris Devoto.
Well, he backs up his heat win with the victory in the main event. Grant, talk about that pass for the lead. That was an exciting one.
You know, I got a pretty good jump. You know, Nathan and I came out of the gate, and we were side by side, and it was weird. You know, normally somewhere along the line, when two guys are battling, they end up hitting each other on the start straight. And we just both went dead straight, and our elbows were almost touching. And came in the first turn, I kind of saw everyone swallowing up, and I just got through the first two turns pretty clean, got in the third, and made a couple passes, got into the lead. And I guess there was some carnage behind me, but I'm glad I missed it. And, you know, my Monster Energy Pro Circuit Kawasaki just got me off to a great start, and it ran great. I mean, our bikes have been fantastic this year, and Anaheim seems to be my lucky place right now, so really stoked to get another win here.
It certainly has been lucky for Grant Langston, our winner in Anaheim yet again.
Langston takes a dominating win tonight in the Supercross Lights main event. Andrew Short comes across the line in second, and Mike Alessi really starting to find some speed as he gets himself on the podium for the second week in a row. Last time Andrew Short came to Anaheim, he finished second, did the same thing tonight. Here's Krista with him.
Yeah, guys, in this one, it was a little ugly there for a second. I know you had a little trouble with that rhythm section, but when Nathan Ramsey went down, you were able to benefit. Talk about that.
Well, I was pretty excited when I saw him down. That's a bad thing to say. Nathan's a great guy, but I got around him, and then, man, it was a wild ride after that. I felt looped out like a beginner. It was crazy, but I rebounded, and I rode as hard as I could for 15 laps, and second is it's good, but it's not as good as first. But that's okay. I had a great night. Honda got me off to a good start and a great performance tonight. Fly Racing, One Industry Helmets, Fly Goggles, Alpine Star Boots. There's so many people that have been helping me, and it's great to get up here on the box for me.
Well, here's what the AMA Supercross Lights West Coast point standings look like now. Andrew Short, one behind Grant Langston, who takes the points lead over. Here's Krista.
On the podium for the second week in a row, it's Mike Alessi. You're getting used to this stuff. Talk about your race tonight.
Yeah, you know, it's a great race. I got the whole shot. And
you know, I was riding good, and I saw Andrew coming up, and he's at the end of the moto, and I didn't think he'd do anything dirty, but I just didn't want to risk it being in third place, you know, a good position and getting better every week in the points. And I'm happy to be up here. You know, I want to thank the KTM Red Bull team, Smith, Alpine Stars, Shark, you know, my mom and dad, the good Lord Jesus Christ, my Dr. Stein, and just all the people that's been close to me, all my family and friends. Thanks a lot.
All right, congratulations, Mike Alessi. Another podium, this time in Anaheim.